How could I not have seen this? But how do we escape ourselves?
The hermit was right. This has driven me mad.
I see you're back with us. Feared we lost you there. Never seen anyone pass out yet stay upright before.
What happened?
I woke up. The illusions I built for myself just fell away. I'm no longer interpreting, I'm experiencing. Everything is perfect.
Really? Have you looked around the colony lately?
No, no. Not perfect in that sense. But it is still perfect. It's all there to be experienced, to be lived. Of course there is pain and loss, but the suffering is caused by trying to control reality. Clinging to the way you want things to be, not enjoying the way they are.
There may be something to that. You seem happy. Or at the very least, not angry.
I am content. I've finally found what I was looking for, even though I was looking for the wrong thing.
Huh.
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged.
Tune in, perk.
What's occupying your thoughts?
I got money and an incense vessel. Now he's got a perk. During the experience at the Hermit's, you seemed somewhat at odds with your mother.
I wouldn't say my parents disowned me, strictly speaking. But before they died, they accused me of thoughtlessly abandoning them. Hmm. I couldn't understand it. I was only trying to make them proud by becoming a better vessel for the plan, to feel the joy they felt. I was so certain my potential was wasted as a laborer, and was willing to risk everything just to prove to them that they were wrong. I was lost, misguided.
But this book?
Bokonu, the author, had some interesting theories about man's perception of reality that I thought could be applied to our attempts to decipher the plan. Unfortunately, he was also one of the founders of the philosophist school of thought, so the book is banned in this colony.
Okay. So he's got a new perk? I didn't get a good look at it. Now we have a incense vessel. Madness in a box, courtesy of the hermit. Here's all the pheromone glands we picked up last episode.
Something on your mind?
So I finished this. Which one is his? Nothing botched, good to know. Illustrated manual. The empty man. Thanks to your help, Max was able to reach a state of enlightenment through the Hermit's vision quest. Max appears to have finished hallucinating. Speak to him to determine if he found the answers he's looking for. Huh. Well, that helps him navigate and fulfill his vision quest by confronting any hallucinations he may encounter during the experience. I guess if we don't confront the hallucinations, it could turn out not so good. Hi.
So, have you found your answers?
Not so much found as finally listened.
Yes, it is quite the convoluted maze we build for ourselves.
Existence is simpler with your eyes closed. It takes courage to open them.
It looks like you learned something in there as well.
I believe I did. I think.
Hearing that brings me great joy, my friend.
I hope your answers you have found are satisfactory. Not really. If they're satisfactory, they must be lies.
All right, well, have a good one. Well, there's only one thing left to do on Scylla, at least now. At least for now, rather. Clyde Harlow, an old friend of Felix from his early days on the Groundbreaker, wants to meet him in person. Harlow told Felix he wants him to be a part of a revolutionary project. Travel to his landing pad on Scylla to have a chat with him. Alright, so I cannot fast travel while near hostiles. I don't know what the hell it is. Those combat drones came back.
Here we go.
Nice one, Captain!
It was fine. She's doing it again. Not you too. I missed where the ash pile went. Alright, let's sell a few things. Alright, so let's go at least start Felix's quest before we leave Scylla. I've acquired a toss ball, yes. Oh wait, no. I'd only go back to the same place.
Some
I have to.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship.
Oh geez, not again.
Now, hold on. What happens if we hit the wall?
Most likely, the bullet will ricochet, which could be bad. Or hilarious.
Seen this? Okay, never mind. Rerun. Okay. So where are we? Where are we going? Scylla. Harlow's base. Max can reflect on what he's learned. We're bringing Felix and Ellie. Because this is Felix's quest. Okay. I hear a vending machine. Forest beans. Well, that's the vending machine. I hear another
one. Vine's got himself a cozy little outfit, huh?
Those guys are either gonna try to shoot us or sell us something potent. Either way, should be fun.
Got a construction mechanical, a Volker, an outlaw, really. Another construction mechanical. Alright. And a hostile yet, so. Let's try to be friendly, even though they're. Well, outlaws aren't always bad. I found that out. Interest around here.
Hey, you. Looking for something?
Yeah.
Where do you think you're going?
Felix Millstone's with me. Clyde Harlow is expecting us.
Yeah. The captain said we might be getting a new recruit. That you, then?
I hope not.
Sounds like Clyde's jumping to conclusions, but yeah. I'm Felix.
You're on a first-name basis with Captain Harlow, huh? All right. Go on through.
Hmm.
Got my sights on you.
Good to know. Let's just look around a little bit.
Nothing to do but stand around and watch the stars go by.
Thanks.
Got my sights on you.
We can go in there if you wanted to. This looks like the drop ship that I was in.
Nothing to do but stand around and watch the stars go by.
That's a steal. What is it? Just some parts? Energy cells? Not worth the risk. I haven't used energy cells for quite a while anyway. So those we can take, but these are steel. That's weird. Is he inside here? He's gotta be inside. Alright, so we have to go inside this place. Hi.
The board comes after us. We'll be ready.
Okay.
Comes after us. We'll be ready.
I've heard. Is it safe to just take from here?
Shh, easy now.
Hello.
That machine stole my bits. Why do we even have one of these? You here to join the crew?
No. At least I can take those.
Hey, Felix. Harlow said you'd be here.
Oops, sorry. I'm tripping over you. Harlow's crew terminal. Welcome to the high ground, soldier. Logs. Acquisitions log. Independent freighter Cat's Meow. Well, that's in the other area, or at least, you know, I saw a journal from it. Hall. Contraband pharmaceuticals. Summary. Brought down salvage cargo ransom crew. Are they the ones responsible for all these crashed, damaged ships? Independent freighter Getaway Sticks. Hall. Subversive literature. Summary brought down salvage cargo. Crew joined up. Freighter. Werewolf. Hall. Engine parts. Summary brought down salvage cargo. Crew jettisoned in escape pod. As usual, we were able to intercept these ships. Despite how cleverly they masked their heat signatures, our patron pulled through again with that tracking data. Don't know how they get their hands on it, but we're in no position to refuse charity. Memo. Crew, I'm beginning to wonder about our patron. When we opened up our scanners and sniffed the system for our latest wildcat, we picked up a signal from a corporate freighter nearby. It was hauling 10 times more cargo than our target. No sooner did we scan it than a message came through, ordering us to go after the wildcat instead. Something doesn't add up. Until I get answers, stay skeptical. Harlow. Open last entry. Pirate crew. Rule number 1, Harlow's the boss. Rule number 2, screw the board. Rule number 3, why are you still reading, pig? Wake up. If you're seeing this, the board already owns you. You went looking for the rules. Why, because life's a game to you? Maybe you like being played. You guzzle down that sense of security like it's purpleberry-flavored opium. Screw rules and screw terminals. It's not a revolution if we're using the weapons they raised against us time and time again. From the front lines of the riots to the corporate sit-ins and... Error. Document Pirate's Code has exceeded character limit. Hi. What you got over there, huh?
Got my sights on you.
Okay, that's what you got? Sights on me. Got it. Good answer, though. That looks like blood.
Been ages since we had a good haul. No freighters, no jobs, no contracts in weeks. Just standing around kicking rocks.
Hmm.
You here to join the crew?
Nope. Can't say I am.
Harlow's right. Board's days are numbered.
Still stuff is steel as well. I'm working my way to that guy. Oh, he's standing right there. Hang on, Felix. We're gonna do a thorough search first. Okay. Well, nothing much else here. Hi.
Well, hey there, Hullhead. Clawed your way out of the groundbreaker at long last?
Uh-huh. Oh, sorry, were you expecting me to say something? Maybe a long time no see or a you've aged, old man?
No, it's fine. I'll do my own introductions. Alicia Clark, Harlow, Harlow, Alicia Clark.
Your captain has a sense of humor, Felix. Good. There's a time and place for humor.
Okay.
So, you took Felix under your wing. Kept him busy. Good. Kid always needed a place to belong.
He had a problem with that.
I don't know what you're trying to say, but he's earned his keep with us.
Right.
Hear that, Clyde? I've been making something out of myself.
So long as you haven't been making a fool of yourself. I'm sure Felix has no end of stories to tell of your exploits together. I look forward to catching up with the boy.
Tell me why we're here.
I'm working on something. Something big. Something the likes of which Halcyon has never seen. And I want Felix to be a part of my initiative. I'm fulfilling a promise I made to the boy. That one day, he and I would change the colony together. That day has finally arrived.
Really?
Easy there, Clyde. No one said nothing about throwing in with you. In case you didn't notice, I'm pretty happy where I am.
I'm not asking you to walk away from your captain, Felix. But neither should you allow yourself to be controlled by fear. Change is not to be feared. I brought you here because I want to know where Felix's loyalties lie. When the day of our revolution comes, I want to know that I can rely on him.
Aw, I would never say that last one's so mean. You want to put him through a test.
Everyone in my crew proves their loyalty. No exceptions. Not even Felix. I want you to deal with a traitor for me. Name's Trask. Kill him, and bring me proof of his death. His ring should do nicely.
What did this Trask do to deserve death?
Ratted us out to the board. He's been an informant. Has been for years. When he realized I was onto him, he and his little cadre mutinied. Killed five of my own and tucked tail. I don't know where he's hiding, but his wife might. Rosanna. Lives on the Groundbreaker last I checked. Rosanna knows my crew by name and face, but you're a stranger to her. She'll talk to you.
There's more to this than you're letting on.
You think so? Maybe we should have a word with Trask. Get his side of the story first.
You'd be wasting your breath bandying words with that traitor. But if it makes you feel better, by all means. Remember, I want proof. Bring me his ring. I don't care if the hand's still attached. Here, my token. Think of this as my personal signature. Anyone who knows me by my works will know me by this token.
Harlow's emblem. How well do you know Felix?
Well enough. It's been a few years, but I still remember a thing or two. You had a chip on your shoulder. You'd argue over anything, and you never backed down.
What do you mean, had? And for the record, you never could admit when you lost an argument.
You see what I had to deal with?
There's something I want to ask you.
Let's hear it.
You said you were working on something big.
A revolution is the work of a lifetime, Captain. I've spent my life preparing for the day of Halcyon's reckoning. Everything you see around you is the result of that preparation. A base of operations, loyal soldiers, freedom from the board's oversight.
What makes you think you're free?
The skies around Scylla are curiously absent of patrol ships. It's almost as if the board's sphere of influence is shrinking. Besides, our facility is well-armed and located on defensible terrain. If the board tries to lay siege to us, we'll make them pay.
Well, it sounds like you've got a plan to overthrow the board.
Hardly. The board is rotting from the inside. Tomorrow, next year, a generation from now, eventually, the board will fall to pieces. Entropy is the natural state of the universe, Captain. All systems inevitably dissolve. When that day comes to Halcyon, we will be ready.
So what's the revolution? If you're not going to rebel against the board, what is this revolution about? Some revolution. You're a band of outlaws living on the edge of an asteroid.
Not all revolutions involve bloodshed and fire, Captain. The purest act of rebellion is to live according to one's own means, independent of any masters. One day, when the board is weak and Halcyon vulnerable, we may claim a piece of this system for ourselves. Until then, we bide our time.
Let's change the subject.
Something on your mind? Let's hear it.
Felix, tell me you disappeared one day.
I was working on this plan for years. Saving every bit I could, drawing plans, biding my time. I never intended to spend my life laboring on the Groundbreaker. When the opportunity presented itself, I did what I had to do. I left.
You might have said something.
I had some ugly business in Scylla. If I told you, I would have implicated you.
Do you mind elaborating on that?
Hephaestus controlled mining operations all over Scylla. Most of these operations failed. The company pulled out and abandoned their facilities. Mostly abandoned, anyway. This one was running on a skeleton crew. My associates and I seized control in a matter of minutes.
All right. Bye. Find Trask. Harlow told you that if Felix wants a place on his crew, he must prove himself by killing a traitor named Rufus Trask. He wants you to find Trask, kill him, and take his ring. Rufus Trask has gone into hiding. Harlow suggested questioning his wife, Rosanna, who can be found on the Groundbreaker. Rosanna! Rosanna! Alright. Well, that's interesting. We don't even know if Felix wants to join his crew. And why do we want to get rid of Felix? Now we discovered the vending machine? It's been here the whole time. Oh, so it's another unbranded vending machine. There's no, you know, jingle. Just some piano music.
A reminder to all crew members. There is only one toilet on the ship.
Are people using some other place as their toilet? I hope not. Tinker with the stuff I want to tinker. So I guess we're going back to the Groundbreaker, because we've got two things to do there now. We got to find Trask, or his wife, rather, and we got to return to... Oh, we can talk to Nyoka now. And we got to report to Dr. Dorset at the sick bay. Let's talk to Nyoka. Since we're right here. Did I capture this thing? Now that Zora's in charge, the Iconoclasts have a fighting chance of surviving and spreading from Monarch. That's why they gave us a banner. That's cool. Same. Mounted Mantiqueen Head. What better to establish dominance over an alien ecosystem than by hunting its most dangerous predator and mounting its head on your wall? That's not the most dangerous. The Mega Mantiqueen is. We got these things up here? That wasn't there before either. Nyoka, I got the glands. I got them.
Get off the pot, damn it.
Hey, Cap.
These glands are gross. Please take them.
Outstanding. These ought to be enough. Let's get back to Monarch.
I was afraid you want
to
say that.
There's an old base I used to call home. I can get us in the door, but we'll have to shoot our way through the Queen's Brood to get to the center.
Hmm.
We'll set the bait there. Password to the door is Charon.
What's Charon? Isn't Charon the other river. There's a river Styx and there's a Charon.
Hayes's idea. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, Nioka.
Oh, Charon. I see.
He said it was some old myth. Something about death and all the things we killed. Rest of us just thought it sounded cool, so there we are.
Remind me, what's this base again?
It's an old cave system we tried to turn into an encampment. You'll see when we get there.
It's about time. I'm gonna kill a Manta Queen. Probably a 14th one.
Fucking right we are.
Haha. Alright. We'll be heading back to Monarch again. But first, let's go to the Ground Breaker. The Grand Braver. Because I have a feeling that, this guy might be on, what do you call it? Monarch. Trask. Opal and Clara's bodies are in the cave somewhere. Find their remains and retrieve their medallions. Alright. First, Trask and or Trask's wife and Dr. Dorset. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.